movement and the birth of nationalism. The response in the late 18th and the early 19th century was restorative in nature. Tribal uprisings and peasant rebellions made an attempt to restore the old order. The second response appeared in the second half of the 19th century in the form of Indian nationalism that imagined India as a nation emphasizing on the consciousness of unity and national aspiration. Peasant uprisings. Peasant revolts began to erupt in the early 19th century and continued till the very end of British rule in India. Many of these revolts were led by religious leaders who treated the British rule as an invasion into the socio-religious life of the people of India. Farazi movement. The Farazi movement, launched by Haji Sariatullah in 1818 in the parts of eastern Bengal, advocated the participants to abstain from Islamic activities. This brought him into direct conflict with the Zamindars and subsequently with British, who favored the Zamindars to suppress the peasant uprising. After the death of Sariatullah in 1839, the rebellion was led by his son Dudu Mayan, who called upon the peasants not to pay tax. Land belongs to God. There were violent clashes throughout 1840s and 1850s with the Zamindars and planters. After the death of Dudu Mayan in 1862, the revolts were revived in the 1870s by Noah Mayan. The Wahhabi rebellion was an anti-imperial and anti-landlord movement. It originated in and around 1827 in the Barasat region of Bengal. It was led by an Islamic preacher, Titu Mir, who was deeply influenced by the Wahhabi teachings. However, the fact that the majority of Zamindars were Hindus gave this movement an anti-Hindu complexion. Titu Mir, along with his 50 soldiers, were killed in the struggle. Tribal uprising. Under colonial rule, for the first time in Indian history, government claimed a direct proprietary right over forests. Munda rebellion. In the 1819s, tribal chiefs offered resistance against the alienation of tribal people from their land and imposition of death bagari or forced labor. The movement received an impetus with Birsa Munda, declared himself as a messenger of God. Birsa claimed that he had a prophecy and promised supernatural solutions to the problem of Munda people and the establishment of Birsaite Raj. The Munda leaders utilized the cult of Birsa Munda to recruit more people to their cause. Finally, the resistance was crushed and Birsa Munda was arrested in February 1900, who later died in jail. The Chota Nagpur Tenancy Act restricted the entry of non-tribal people into the tribal land. Indian Revolt of 1857 or Sepoy Mutiny. This denotes the revolution started by the soldiers of the English East India Company on 10th May 1857. At Meerut in India. Later, this revolution spread at many places in India, especially it spread at central mountainous regions. The main revolutionary areas were centered at today's Uttar Pradesh, North Madhya Pradesh, Delhi. These revolutionaries were really a challenge for the Britishers. After the fall of Gwalior on June 20, 1858, this revolution came to an end. This was called as India's First War of Independence.